Better here? Or better here? Better here? Or better here? You don't want to be walking around blind at Christmas, Miss Ryer. Help me out.
I don't need glasses.
You need binoculars. We're settling for glasses. Better one?
Glasses will make me look old.
Try these.
I look hot.
Evening, Father Bruce.
Hello, Dr. Finch.
Hello, Miss Patterson.
Hello, Dr. Finch.
Dr. Finch!
Ah, hello, Gustav, Goethe.
I'd love to chat and so, but you know how focused Goethe gets on our runs.
Oh, oh!
Oh, Goethe!
Oh, dein Sie vorsichtig! Auf Wiedersehen!
Wiedersehen? You should maybe get that looked at. Start wearing some padding.
Yes, well, I'm sure it's more fun your way, Arturo, but I need you to hang the decorations on the tree, not just chuck them up there and hope they stick.
Hey, Steve.
Yeah, Mayor Young.
What do you think?
Oh, looking good.
Thank you.
Is that an angel on top?
Oh, it's supposed to be, but we couldn't find one big enough. But fortunately, my wife has a porcelain doll collection, so she lent us her Marilyn Monroe.
Nice touch. Well, it looks good. Yeah, don't go overboard with the lights, though. We don't want to seem tacky.
Oh, whatever you say, Steve. Winterfest is your baby. Hey, hey, we got any big surprises this year?
Come on.
Nobody keeps a secret better than me. For instance, I know for a fact Sheriff Dave is a cross-dresser. I never told a soul. Until today.
Hi, honey. I'm home.
It's the raw quail eggs, isn't it? It's the texture, right? The grainy, slimy, milky. Can you taste the curry?
Yeah. Yeah. Gee, I sure hope there's more of that.
You are such a bad liar. I knew it was awful. It's awful, right?
Yeah.
Who wants pizza?
My life just isn't working out the way I thought it would.
Excuse me?
Oh, honey, you don't mean that.
I'm 10. What have I really accomplished? Half season of soccer? Cleared legendary mode of Halo? A lackluster stint in the Cub Scouts?
Hey, I guess what day it is. Come on, guess. Maddie?
I don't know. I don't care.
Wrong. It's December 1st. Time to break out the Christmas calendar. Yes, this is a busy time of year, so we have to have a game plan. Okay, December 3rd, we hang the wreath.
You just get so intense about Christmas.
Not intense, I'm just extremely organized.
When you're talking about Christmas caroling, you shouldn't have to use the term flanking maneuver.
Look, I know it's only December 1st, but I have all the planning to do for the Winterfest. You have a cookbook to write, the kids have school. It all goes by so quickly. Before you know it, Christmas will be over.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean that we have to plan every second.
Look, my dad dragged me from one Air Force base to another. Christmas was not a priority for him. We didn't even have a tree. Well, I want things to be different for my kids. I want them to have big family traditions year after year that they can count on and look forward to.
You're right. I'm gonna try to be more supportive.
Well, you should be. Madison is a loner. She has hardly any friends. Carter's a 10-year-old boy with a midlife crisis. Let's face it, our kids are a little weird. Well, I think this year they need Christmas more than ever.
You're right. I'm sorry. You're right. Snowmen eggnog caroling. We're gonna do it all, okay?
Okay.
And I don't write cookbooks.
What?
You always say that I write cookbooks, but I don't. I just edit other people's recipes, and then I compile them into cookbooks that nobody buys.
Well, then write your own.
Oh, great. So all the rejection would just be more personal? No, thank you.
Well, I think you should.
Really?
Yeah, I think you could.
Really?
Sure. What is that?
Is it a truck?
I don't know.
Looks like we have new neighbors.
Who moves in the middle of the night? A meth lab?
How bad could it be?
Spazzing out on me. It looked like you're having a seizure. Well, I got tasered once. It looked exactly like that. And I'm man enough to say, I wet myself.
Who are you?
I'm Buddy Hall. We just moved in across the street. You don't happen to have a cat, do you?
No.
Oh, good, because I was moving in last night. I accidentally dropped a fridge on one. Thank God most of it got away.
Buddy!
Tia! Come on over and meet the... What's your name?
Finch. Steve Finch. But this isn't really a very
Come
good
and meet
guy.
Steve.
Good morning.
Oh, well, Steve, you have a way with the ladies.
Oh, thank you.
This is my wife, Kelly. This is Buddy.
Hi. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
I measured and the ceiling's too low in the bedroom. We're going to have to get a shorter pole.
Morning.
Hi. Oh, what did he do? Try to steal your paper?
No, I was just being neighborly.
I'll leave you alone for 5 minutes.
Looks like we got a visitor.
Whoa!
Don't put the little guy away on my account.
Tia, this is Kelly. Kelly, this is Tia.
Hi. So nice to meet you.
You too.
You have kids, right?
We do.
Well, why don't you come on over and we should talk about maybe starting a carpool or something.
That sounds great. Welcome.
Thank you.
Bye.
Hey. Here. Good.
I can't believe you're making me do this.
We're just gonna stop and say hello.
Come on in, it's open.
Hello?
Oh, good. Oh, honey, could you come over here and give me a little boost?
Oh, sure.
Seriously, sweetie, I'm about to break my neck here. Just yank it up there. Yeah, just, yeah, a little bit harder.
Oh,
yeah, more up. Whoa!
There you go.
Woo, that's one way to get acquainted, huh?
Oh, these are for you.
Oh, thank you. Oh, I love blueberry. Right to the hip. And who do we have here?
This is Madison.
Say hello, Madison.
Hello, Madison.
She's 15, you know how they get.
You're kidding me.
Mm-mm.
15? My girls are 15. Girls, get your butts down here, we've got company.
Carter, you're staring.
Oh, sorry about that. I used to do a little modeling, mostly for art classes at the community college. That's how I met Buddy.
Really? Was he an artist?
Nah, they caught him peeking in through the windows.
That's such a sweet story.
You know, I just got so tired of dating boys. No offense. Mm. Then one day I met Buddy and just swept me right off my feet. Oh, there you are. These are my babies, Ashley and Emily.
Hi, girls.
Hi.
This is Madison and this is Carter.
Hi.
Oh, you know, you girls will probably be in a lot of the same classes.
Great. Are there any hot guys? Yeah. But, you know, they're all enormous tools.
Really?
Will you entertain us?
Kelly, thank you. That has been my family for years.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Well, it ought to be. It's worth more than this entire house put together. Let me just find a safe place for it, and we'll see about getting these kids to school.
Oh, you know, I can drop them all at school if you want to stay here and unpack.
Really?
Sure.
You do that for me?
Yeah, no problem. I'll bring the car around while they get dressed.
Oh, they are dressed. Trust me, this is more clothes than they've worn in months.
Can I live here?
Get in the car.
You got a fake ID?
No.
Don't worry, I can make you one.
Nice girls.
Kidding me? I pray every day for the strength not to run over the both of them with a truck. Have a nice day.
All right, listen up, you guys. We just got in a new shipment of aspens, and I want you to sell 3 for me by lunchtime. All right.
What are you kidding?
Hey, we got a new salesman, Buddy Hall over here. Let's make him feel welcome. Come on, yeah? All right. Welcome aboard. Sell. All right. Oh, buddy. Hey, you ready to sell some cars?
Me? I'm a born car salesman. But I was thinking today that maybe I would just kind of ease into it. You know, get a feeling for the place.
Yeah, well, you see that tire kicker right there? He's all yours.
I don't know. I
got $1,000 says you can't sell him.
Oh, let me in on that action.
Yeah, well, let's just make it three.
Three?
3 G's.
All right, you guys are asking for it.
There's one more in every minute.
Tennis is genius.
You can't let these new guys get into a rhythm. I'm telling you, boys, from this day forward, we own that guy.
There we go. The brush off.
That's the brush off.
Okay, here we go. Gotcha.
Are you okay?
You walk face first into that buzzsaw.
Money on my desk by the end of the day. No checks.
That's not possible.
Mr. Murray owns the dealership.
I just bought one of my own cars. And the worst part is, I paid sticker.
Hey, girls.
Hey, Dad.
Hi, Dad.
And?
Sold the car in the first 5 minutes.
Buddy, no.
Oh, my God. I told you things were going to work out. Yeah, great. Yeah. My baby.
It's great. So great, so great, 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 great. Yeah.
You start out great, you lose interest, and the next thing you know, I'm up to my neck in cardboard boxes.
No, it's great. I'm a car salesman.
Hey, that's a good job.
Yeah, it's a great job, great job. Car salesman, carpets, copiers.
Futons.
It's all the same. I don't know, I was just hoping that, you know, one day I'd do something big, something important. Something monumental.
You are. You're going to pay off our monumental debt.
Oh.
Buddy, you promise me.
Ooh. Well, I keep my promise.
Yeah, it's a little.
Everything's going to be great.
Daddy.
Daddy, come look. We got something real cool.
Oh, the honeys.
Hey, Dad.
What do you got going here?
It's my Earth.
My Earth?
You type in an address, and you can see every house in the country from space.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Emily's already used it to track the, like, 5 hottest guys in school.
Yeah, Dad. 3 of them live 2 blocks from here.
Well, that's more math than you've done in years.
Did it hurt? Loser.
Easy. You can see every house from space?
Yeah.
Let's see. Where's our house?
Oh, you can't see our house, but you can see the neighbors.
I figures we're invisible.
Buddy, that's trash.
Space, huh? Of course you can see the big house. Ooh.
see it from space. I'll light it up. Not gonna be invisible anymore.
Oh, man. Buddy? Buddy?
Hey, Steve!
Do you have any idea what time it is?
What's the matter? All the clocks in your house busted?
No, I know what time it is.
Oh, what, do you just need an excuse to come over here in your underwear?
No, I was being sarcastic.
Oh. Well, you gotta know that stuff like that just goes right over my head. Here, hold these things. I want to strand them out.
No, I will not hold on to this. That's why I came over here. You're making all kinds of noise. Do you have any idea how bright your house is?
Yeah, it's pretty damn bright. Look at that. Whoa! Oh, is that what's bothering you? The lights?
Yes, that's right.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to. I'll turn them off.
Thank you.
Oh.
Thank you.
Steve. Are we going to be friends? Because... you know, we just moved into the neighborhood, and boy, it would be bad if I ticked off the only guy I know. That would kill me.
Well, maybe I overreacted a little bit.
Nah, you know, I can be a real jerk sometimes.
Maybe we should just start completely over.
Buddy Hall, and you are?
No, I didn't mean we should literally. I was speaking metaphorically.
That's it. I don't. Sometimes my stupidity astounds me. I got an idea. How about if you and I come up with a series of hand signals so I'll know when you're gonna talk weird?
I'll see you tomorrow.
This is gonna be good. Come on.
So late.
Honey, get that satellite image up that you had before. Go on. Here, honey, you sit here.
Really?
Yeah, sit right there and watch.
So many buttons. I'll
do it. Okay, you do it. Where are you going? Stick around. I want you to see this.
You still can't see it.
You're gonna miss it.
Sorry, Daddy.
What do you mean you can't see it? It's impossible. I put so many more lights on.
Well, how are you gonna get it? You'll get it.
I gotta go bigger. Oh, hi. Can you order me more of these?
Sure.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What's that?
You're gonna love this.
It's a horse-drawn sleigh.
Don't see many of these around anymore.
No, you don't.
Nice.
I'll take it.
No.
Come on.
No.
Why?
Get away from me with that.
What do you mean?
I'm serious. I'll call child services. One look at that and they will put you away.
Maddie, we always wear matching sweaters for the family Christmas car. Come on, it's all right. Huh? Aw, please. Hmm? Look, huh? Please.
Are we ready?
There, you see Mom's wearing hers.
Okay, Mom's old and married, all right? She doesn't need the self-esteem. I still have something to live for.
It's true. Madison's right. She's got her whole life ahead of her. It's more than I can say for some of us.
Come on, he does this every year. He starts acting all depressed so people feel bad for him and buy him bigger presents.
Hey, the new neighbors have reindeer!
Reindeer?
Wait.
Hey, Steve, what do you think?
Oh, my God.
It's so cute. Where in the world did you find it?
Eugenia, down at the hardware store, sold it to him. Isn't it beautiful?
Oh, beautiful. Yes, and these horses. These horses, I especially like the way you've duct taped the antlers to their heads.
Yeah, well, apparently reindeer are not indigenous to the region.
That sweater is really cool.
Yeah, is it Marc Jacobs?
Oh, you know, I'm not sure. I have so many, it's kind of hard to keep track these days.
Well, this has been fun. So let's go take the picture, huh?
Wait, What picture? Are you talking about your Christmas picture?
Mm-hmm.
You should take it here in the sled.
Oh,
that's a great idea.
That's a horrible idea because we always take our picture in front of the fireplace. It's a tradition.
But wouldn't it be nice to try something new this year, honey?
No, I don't think so.
Here,
no.
Here's a hat.
No.
Take the picture in the sled.
Oh, no.
You put the Santa suit on.
No, no.
Yes, no. You're going to take the picture in the sled.
That's
the way to do it.
Hey, Clark, Carter.
There you go.
Carter, get out of that.
All right,
right now.
We should keep our voices down a little bit because I found these horses on the outskirts of town. And between you and me, they look a little skittish to me.
You found these horses?
Yeah.
Carter, out of that death trap, now!
Okay, all right,
Carter, let's go.
Give me the rein.
Give me the rein, Carter. Let's go.
Pull the rein. Coming too. Think he's gonna be all right.
Where am I?
We're in the back seat of your wife's car on the way to the hospital. You warming up?
Yeah. Where are my clothes?
You were freezing to death. We had to get you out of them.
Where are your clothes?
I had to get your body temperature up, so I stripped us both down and zipped us into this sleeping bag. Trust me, it works. I've done it a half a dozen times. Ah! Oh, ah! Calm down.
The doctor said he probably saved your life.
Which is only fair, since he's the one who almost got me killed in the first place. Oh, this used to be such a nice, quiet neighborhood. Look at it now. People driving by all night. You see that? I think he's tapping into our power.
Yes, and in the process, he is stealing our very souls.
Well, how do you think he's powering all those lights of his?
Honey, I really think you're wrong about him. Look at what he dropped off. He knew he didn't get a chance to take a picture for a Christmas card, so look what he made from a picture he took at the hospital. That's you, with the blue lips.
Yeah.
Yeah, and a cute little oxygen tube coming from your nose.
Yeah, I picked up on that, thanks.
Come on now, that is a nice gesture, don't you think?
Okay, yeah, maybe.
I think that we should take them with us to get the treat.
No.
Yes, because I really like Tia. She's taken a real interest in my cookbooks, and you just need to find a way to get along with Buddy.
Okay, but he's not touching any of my trees.
Okay, fine, but they're coming with us.
Hey, Mom. Hey, Dad. I was thinking, maybe you could take me Christmas shopping for Mom. We could go to the mall and wander around. Oh, and we can get hot chocolate.
You know what? Already taken care of. You're getting her a really nice sweater that I ordered from a catalog.
Oh. I guess that means we don't have to go to the mall together.
Yeah. Isn't that great? That place is an insane asylum this time of year.
Hey, you see that?
Yeah.
You did?
This is amazing, honey. Look.
Wow.
Woo.
It's a nice tree, honey.
Nice. It's perfect. A 12-foot silver noble. Yes, sir. This is the way God intended trees to look.
What do? Chop them down or launch them?
Laugh all you want, but I got the next 5 years of trees all lined up, and each one of them is perfect. No twisted trunks, no bald spots.
Well, it's certainly a dandy tree, I'll give you that. Honeys, let's go.
Yeah, Dad, let's find a really big one.
Yeah,
but it has to be pretty.
Hey, the last ones to the car are losers.
Please, it's not like it's a race. Give him the axe, Carter. No way he beats us.
Honey, you said he could cut it down.
Well, he can do it next year. Come on, give me the axe.
It's all right, sweetheart. Come on.
What's the record?
Wow, Dad, you know, I think I wrote it down in my diary, but I must have forgot.
Haha, very funny. But we'll be halfway home by the time he...
Huh. Does anyone smell gas?
Well, it's probably me, but cut me some slack. I'm swinging pretty hard. Years I've been growing those trees.
He obviously didn't mean to do it, honey. It was an accident.
He did offer to cut you down a tree, Dad.
Finches always have a silver noble tree. It's a tradition, and thank God they had one left. You get the tree, son.
All right, here we go. Keep it up. That's a girl.
Oh. I'm pretty sure you broke the record cutting this one down, Dad.
Better there? Christmas tree at better there? Christmas party hop. Better one? Mistletoe hung where you can better two?
Hey! Hi, guys! Hi, guys!
Hey,
thanks for coming! Merry Christmas!
Oh, honey, the girls are having so much fun showing everybody the lights. I pray to God that's all they're showing them. You coming out?
I'm gonna run a sequencer on the lights.
Buddy!
Synchronize it to the music.
Are you deaf?
These people are depending on me to give them something amazing. And that's just what I'm gonna do.
Is it me? Oh, God.
It's probably a good idea to have a fire extinguisher around.
You think?
Hmm.
Ah, no. More lights now. Buddy. Buddy. Hey, what are you doing?
Hi,
more
Steve.
Lights? Getting more lights?
Yeah.
Is that your shop across the street? This is wrong. No, all this has to go
just
back. All this goes
I
back.
I needed to see. What do you think of the tree for Winterfest?
Well,
Steve, I was talking to Buddy here. I mean, after all, he is the expert. Come on, would you have a look?
Watch my stuff, Steve.
Ah. Hey, folks, everything's free today. Anything you want, it's all free.
I love the three-colored strands of lights. The spacing is great.
Oh, thank you.
The ornaments, well dispersed. Oh, yes. I see you're using my bulb of choice, the C9.
Yeah. Yeah.
Very nice.
Yeah.
That adds a lot of class to that tree. I love it.
Oh,
really
thank
good.
You.
Really.
He likes it.
Hey, Steve.
He
likes that. It. That is a tree.
Yes, it is.
Huh?
Yeah. Listen, we need to get something straight. Around here, I'm the Christmas guy.
Really?
Yeah, yeah. It's a,
It's kind of my thing. Chris has Memorial Day, Pete has the 4th of July, but I have Christmas.
Oh. Yeah.
But hey, you can have Halloween.
Yeah, good. Halloween.
Yeah, sure. Throw a couple of pumpkins in the yard, a skeleton or two. You can jump out and scare people. It'll be great. Mm-hmm. What do you think?
I don't think so.
No?
This Winterfest thing, what is this all about?
Oh, it's our annual Christmas carnival.
Oh.
Yeah, we have a show, games, ice sculpture, races. I happen to be the chairman. It's a pretty prestigious position.
Mm. Yeah, races? What kind of races?
Speed skating.
Speed skating?
Speed skating. We do it right here. They actually put the ice down right here on Main Street.
Oh, I used to do a little speed skating myself.
Really? Well, so did I.
Excuse me. Wallace Fiskin.
Oh, Buddy Hall.
Sir, meeting you is one of the great moments of my life.
Well, thank you, Wallace. It's a pleasure to meet you.
So anyway, how do you feel about the liberal use of mistletoe?
Well, I feel that you should go sparingly around the threshold, because that's a cliche.
Please.
My mission is clear.
Wallace, thank you. Good luck. Would you take this inside
my
for
pleasure.
Me? Steve. Oh, Steve. I guess I'm the new Christmas guy. That's okay. You can take Toe Jam Day.
Oh. This isn't over yet. We're just getting started. I'm the Christmas guy. I'm the Christmas guy.
Me.
Honey, Tia just gave me a great idea. I'm gonna write my own cookbook.
That's my girl.
Tia gave you the idea. I've been telling you to do that for years.
You know what? It should be a cookbook for real moms who cook for real families.
Yes. And I have the title for you. Food with Kelly Finch.
I love it!
Dad, there's about 50 singing dorks waiting for you in the front yard.
50? Isn't that great?
You know what? You are gonna help me write the cookbook.
Okay.
Yes?
Be happy to.
Yay!
Mom!
Wow, nice!
Oh, where are your clothes?
Calm down, Dad. I have a jacket.
Well, keep it zipped.
So, where are the twins?
Well, they'll be over just as soon as the boys get here.
Boys? Madison is not allowed to date.
Honey, don't worry. It's a one-time thing. They ship out next week.
They're in the Navy?
Bye, Dad.
Wait!
Hey! Hey!
Thank you for coming. Thank you for braving the insanity. I have the songbooks here, so let's pass them along to yourselves.
Haven't seen Kinder Brunschweiger?
Oh, yes. Do you have, there's an acorn in my stocking?
No. Haven't seen die Hofensteig?
Yes. Do you have the Ignorance Snowman?
No, I don't think I do,
hey,
but we can...
Hey, there's a news crew over at the halls.
Yeah, it really is quite a spectacle. Anyway, I thought that we would start with one of my very favorites, the Holly and the Ivy. Pitch pipe.
Hi. Have a good time. Same way.
Sorry,
honey.
Hi.
Thanks for coming.
Light up the show.
Light up the show. What y'all know about Christmas cheer?
Light up the show. I love that song.
No, wait, come back. Come back here. We're not done with rehearsal. Come back, we're going caroling. It's a tradition, everybody. Honey, you.
Huh? I'm not going anywhere.
Where are the kids?
Oh, look.
They're going to be making kissing und so.
Yeah, kissing und so.
Well, hello there. We're from Channel 8 News, and we would love to have an interview.
There they go.
Yeah. Hi. I'm just very happy that everyone likes the lights.
Yes, indeed. Obviously, you have put an awful lot of work into this.
Oh, yeah. And I'm nowhere near being finished.
Oh, are you kidding me? Jesus. Christ, the Lord is born this Christmas morn.
Look at that. The lights have obviously brought out the Christmas spirit in everyone.
Yeah, they bring out the Christmas spirit in everybody. Yeah, I'm really happy about that.
Oh,
and
my gosh.
I'm not going to stop until I have the biggest and brightest light display in the world.
Oh, please.
I really want my house to be seen from space.
Oh my God.
Outer space.
Honey, wait. Wait, what are you gonna do?
You heard him, didn't you? This is gonna stop tonight. We'll see what Sheriff Dave has to say about this. Does anybody know who these RVs belong to? Anybody?
Why, you wanna make me an offer?
No, I need to get out.
Okay, scoot on through.
I don't know.
I swear to God, if man can't drive anymore, I'll tell you what, little buddy, you hold my beer, I'll do it for you.
Okay, okay, I'll do it, I'll do it. Just guide me out.
All right. Hey, you could probably use a few more lights on your house, don't you think?
Look at that thing.
All right, you ready?
You sure?
That's why I'm here, buddy. Don't worry, I'm watching you. I'm watching. A little bit to your right. No, no, your other right. Yeah, come on.
I can't see the other side at all.
No, that's okay. I'm your eyes. I'm your eyes. Straight back.
Doesn't look like enough room to me.
Oh, God.
Oh, boy.
Ugly. Okay, okay, it's all right. At this point, it's like pulling off a Band-Aid. You gotta just gun it, you know what I mean? Okay, you ready? One, two, gun it!
Dave, you have to do something about my neighbor's house.
Oh, yeah, yeah, the hall place. I take my kids by there every night after dinner. I tell you, it just keeps getting bigger and bigger.
Yes, well, that's why I want you to arrest him.
Arrest him? Uh-huh. On what charge?
Light trespass.
Light trespass?
Uh-huh. Yes, light trespass. When bright, uncontrolled light shines in neighboring property or windows as to cause a public nuisance. Well, I'm public, and I've been, nuisanced.
Well, I can't arrest a man for decorating. What are you looking at? What, this?
No, no, I don't mind if you wear a bra. looks like a nice one.
It's a brace. My wife made it for me. Oh. I dislocated my shoulder. It keeps it from popping back out.
Sure.
What'd you think? Do you think I was wearing a bra?
No, that would be crazy.
Now, as far as the lights are concerned, I'm saying it's Christmas.
Mm-hmm.
And you've got a lot on your mind. Well, the Winterfest coming up, but if you want to file a complaint, I'll fill out the paperwork.
I do, thank you. I appreciate it. I want to file a complaint.
Now, where is that form? Yes. Ah, here we are. Dr. Finch?
Yo. Slaterman, what happened? I woke up and you were gone. What are you doing out here? Honey, you've really been doing a lot of work.
Yeah.
That looks amazing.
I guess the light thing is pretty stupid, isn't it?
Oh, honey. Yeah, it is. Come on, it's the stupidest thing I've ever heard. You want our lights to be seen from space. Certifiable.
I'll take them all down tomorrow.
No, you touch one bulb on that house, and you've seen the last of my special holiday offers, and I think you know what I mean.
You just said they look stupid.
Yeah, it's crazy. But all good ideas are crazy.
These are lights.
Oh, come on. I think we both know it means more to you than just who knows? Might turn out to be something monumental.
I can always count on you, can't I?
Sure.
Oh, cow. You have to put in milk pancakes tomorrow.
What is he up to now?
Oh, he's bringing in animals for a live manger scene.
Unbelievable. Is that a camel?
Oh, look at that.
Yep. Can't wait to bring my kids by.
Well, if you want to make sure they see it, you better bring them tonight. Let's light this candle.
What are you doing?
Oh, what are you doing up anyway? It's late, you should go to bed. Zip up your coat.
You're gonna cut his power, aren't you? Need a lookout? SpongeBob, this is SquarePants. The tiger is in the cage.
Roger that, SquarePants. I'm going in.
Roger.
This is the best Christmas ever.
Stop. Tigers left the enclosure.
Hello.
He's coming! Hi!
Oh, good Lord.
That's disgusting. No. No, get away from me. Hi, hon. Couldn't sleep?
What the hell are you doing over there? Oh, my God. You smell. Were you with the camel?
I did it. The lights are off. Isn't it great?
Little help, please.
Sorry, Mom.
It was his idea.
Get him down right now.
All right, but tonight, when you're getting your best sleep in weeks, remember, I did it. The lights are off. The lights are finally on.
Grandma got run over by a reindeer. Walking home from our house Christmas Eve.
See that? You that was a close one. The lights went out.
Yeah, we came right over to see if there's anything we could do to help, buddy. What's that noise?
Oh, that's the Generac 3000. Liquid cool generator. Comes in really handy in a pinch like this, don't you think?
Very handy.
Well, everything seems to be in order here, honey. Mm-hmm. I think we should go to bed. Good night, buddy.
Excuse me. Is that your son dangling from that telephone pole?
Hi, Mr. Hall.
We're having him tested.
Good night. Thank you very much.
Go get him right now.
Coming, Carter.
Thank you.
Where's my paper? Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Kelly! He's messing with the wrong hombre. I'm making the call. Yeah, the neighborhood association is not gonna stand by with this.
The color, we could change it out.
Buddy. Buddy, the tree? A car?
It's an amazingly generous gesture, but we can't possibly accept it.
Oh, yeah, it's too much. Then again, we don't want to be rude.
Steve?
Well, I drive a car with no doors. We live in Massachusetts. I could die.
The car is yours. I'm not going to take no for an answer. After all I put you through, that's all there is to it. The keys are inside. Enjoy.
Oh, thank you so much.
This is great.
Enjoy.
Thank you. I'll get the electrician to come by this morning and fix the fuse box.
Yes, I think you better.
I will. What happened?
Yeah, vandals. They took a chainsaw to it last night. Stole the whole thing, decorations and all.
Gee. Nah. You couldn't have. It can't be the same tree.
Dr. Finch, this came for you from the car dealer?
Oh. Probably the documentation.
They say you have to pay for the car by lunchtime. You're going to be arrested.
Arrested? Arrested, but that car...
Bob, you want to see me?
Yeah, hey, buddy. Come on in here. Yes, grab a seat. Let me just send that important thing off there. Hey,
yeah.
Look, I know you think I'm young and maybe a little inexperienced, but the truth is you don't get to where I am without knowing a thing or two about the art of selling cars.
Actually, Bob, you got to where you are because your dad owns the business.
Look, yeah, you know what? We're getting off task here. No. It's not important. What's important here is this month's sales figures. They just came in.
Bob, what are we doing here? I should be out there selling cars.
Hey, whoa. Hold up there, Goose. Come on. Come on back inside here. Look, you're a great salesman. Everybody knows that, all right?
Thank you.
But the problem is your numbers are way down, buddy. All right? You can't sell cars if you're never here.
Bob, it's the lights, the Christmas lights. See, all my life I've been looking for that one thing, that one important thing. And I've always quit everything I started. I can't quit this, Bob. I gotta finish this.
Right. Well, if finishing those lights means more time away from work, then... I can pretty much guarantee you're not gonna have a job to come back to when you're done.
Buddy Hall, you have a customer in the showroom.
Duty calls. Hey, Steve!
What is this? Hey, what is this? What's inside here?
Well, I don't have my x-ray goggles with me, but I'm guessing that's the bill to the new car you bought.
I didn't buy a car. You gave me a car, and I know about the tree.
Tree? The tree? What tree? I don't know about any tree. And unless they have film on it, you don't know about any tree. They don't have film on it, do they?
You chopped down the town Christmas tree and stuck it in my living room, and you made me believe that car was a present.
Steve, if you would have looked at the bill, you would have noticed that I shaved my commission by almost a third, which in most circles is quite a substantial gift.
Well, your gift is parked outside.
Steve, you cannot walk away from your obligations. You signed the contract.
I didn't sign anything.
No, that's true. You didn't sign anything. I had to forge your signature. Otherwise, they wouldn't let me drive the car out of here.
Okay, that's it. We are going to settle this like men.
Who?
I'm going to contact my attorney.
Oh, you're going to contact your attorney. Is that the way you settle things like men? What's the matter? Your mommy out of town?
Okay. You want to go? Let's go outside right now. Come on, let's do it. I'm going to kick your ass.
Whoa. Take it easy, Jackie Chan. Relax. We're not barbarians.
What do you want to do?
Well, there's the little Winterfest coming up. And in the Winterfest, there is an ice skating race.
Yeah. Yeah, great idea. Great idea. You win, I buy the car. I win, you take down the lights.
Deal. Tree set. It's a beautiful car. It's fully loaded. You spared no expense. Frozen ball. I'm gonna knock the little hairs off that little Russian guy.
Do it.
I think you should do it.
Do it like I know you can.
Little wooden man going down. Zinga.
Touchdown.
All right. Come on, son. Let's show him how it's done.
Hello, Steve.
Hello.
Hello.
Okay.
Yeah.
Give him $5, son.
My dad's gonna win.
Ah, southpaw.
Watch and learn.
Look at the two of them. Why are they working so hard at hating each other?
I don't know. Why can't they just be quiet and do it with a big smile on their face like normal neighbors?
Yeah. That mean man knocked down the old lady. He just winged her.
That's gonna swell up. Too late to back out. Pinch.
What are they doing now?
Oh, this is just getting embarrassing.
On your mark, get set. Whoa!
They're acting like a bunch of 12-year-olds. I mean, I can't.
She's right. This is crazy.
Now, I don't care if it takes all day. You're going to stand here and you're going to work it out.
Well, there's nothing to work out.
You see? I told you can't talk to a guy like this. It's a waste of time. Ow!
Ow, ow. Why'd you hit me?
I don't know. She started it.
Don't be such babies. Now, this is important to us. And it better be important to you, too. Talk it out.
Thank you, Dave.
I don't know what we're supposed to say.
There is nothing in the universe that we could agree on.
Well, you got that right.
Okay, everybody, now let's give a nice, warm Winterfest welcome to the Santa Baby.
Now that is something we could agree on. I mean, that's got it going on. Yeah, look at that. You ready?
Yes.
Well, you're a guy, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, come on. Hey! Is it getting hot out here, or is it just you girls? Oh, nice dip.
Wow!
Ow!
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Woo.
Hey, baby, who's your daddy?
Yeah.
Who's your daddy? Who's your daddy?
Oh, God, I'm your daddy.
I'm your daddy.
Oh.
I'm your daddy. Ah!
My eyes!
Oh, God!
My eyes!
We're going to hell.
You think I don't know that?
You know, for 1 second, I let myself think you were a normal guy, and this is what happened.
Blame me for this? Who's your daddy? Who's your daddy?
The annual Winterfest speed skating races will begin in 5 minutes.
In the world of sport, it has no equal. Modern-day gladiators throwing caution to the wind, risking their very lives for a chance at immortality. Okay, so they're not risking their lives, but they are skating pretty fast, and it's really cool. It's Winterfest's 9th annual speed skating race.
Okay, is that everybody? Nope. Looks like somebody got cold feet. Let's start the race.
Wait.
Oh, very nice. Very nice suit. Looks like you're smuggling a couple of chicken nuggets up there.
It's a skin suit. I raced in college.
Go, Dad!
Thank you, Carter.
Dad, he's our man. If he can't do it, nobody can.
Dad!
On your mark, bunnies, get set, go!
Finch is down!
Oh.
And he looks bad. Wait, he's back up. He's on his feet and he's skating fast, but he's got a lot of ice to catch up.
And into the first turn, it's Buddy Hall, Gustav, and Gerda. Finch really appears to be struggling as he rounds turn two and heads for the straightaway. Wait, Mayor Eugene Young has yet to leave the starting line. Gustav and Gerda make their move on Buddy in turn number three, and they've taken the lead. Buddy Hall seems to be running out of gas. The crowd urges him on, but it may not be his day. Wrong way Fink slips past Gustav and Gerda and is really pouring it on.
Finch has got to make his move now or else. Once again, he jumps the bail, almost taking out Buddy in the process. And miraculously, Steve Finch is taking the lead, going into the final turn. Steve Finch has a huge lead. Nothing can stop him now. Finch is sent sprawling. Oh, the carnage.
And he's putting all my nose. I will be back with the payment booklet for your new car, Flash.
Yeah, fine. But the last time I looked at the satellite pictures, I still couldn't see your house. Not a flicker. Not a blip. How's that feel, huh? How's it feel to be invisible? Huh? What?
Okay, let's go over it. The LED lights, the grid, the wires, the shipping, the handling, everything. The whole ball of wax, how much, out the door. How much? What? Are you serious? What is that, in yen? Is that with the discount? Can you get it here overnight?
Buddy Paul!
Hi, honey.
This is a bad dream, right? I'm gonna wake up and this won't be happening.
No. I'm just gonna take a couple of these branches off so that we get.
Not talking about the trees. Talking about this.
What's that?
You know exactly what this is. This is the stand to my vase. You pawned it, didn't you? You pawned my grandmother's vase.
Well, how am I supposed to afford a camel on a car salesman's salary? And then I went for a loan, and if you don't have a job...
You lost your job?
Oh. That was a pretty awkward way for you to find that out. But don't worry about it. I can sell anything to anybody.
Not me. Not anymore.
Oh, honey, things are gonna get better.
When? I'm tired of waiting, buddy. Waiting for you to find the right job, the right town.
waiting for you to find that one true thing that makes you happy.
I think this is it!
You see, that's just the thing, buddy. I just thought you might wake up one day and see that it just might be me. That it just might be your family. You know what? I'm done.
Oh, honey. Oh, come on, don't. Come on. Please, baby. No. Oh, no, honey.
Buddy Hall's Christmas wish is to make his house bright enough to be visible not just from miles around, but from space.
Oh, right. When we heard about Mr. Hall's, quest, if you will, we decided to downlink images from his general area as often as possible, so I can show you if you'd like to take a look. Right. Nothing yet.
Wow, thank you for that. This may be one Christmas wish even Santa can't grant.
Hi, everybody. Thanks for coming. I'm really happy that you came tonight. I hope you enjoy these lights, because I did them all for you, and for my family, and for my wonderful neighbors across the street. Thank you. If you missed anything, this show is going to be repeated every night on a loop until 4 a.m.
I can't take it anymore.
Well, me neither, but take some of the blame.
You hear that?
Yeah.
You hear that? It's getting louder. He wants to play rough? I can play rough.
Steve, where are you going? Steve!
I hear if someone's in the market for something with little pop, you're the guy.
Maybe. Could be the guy. Depends on what you're looking for.
Don't let the reindeer pajamas fool you, pal. I'm not playing around. I'm looking to do some serious damage.
Yeah? Cool. And you come to the right place. Because I got enough firepower back here for two wars. I got Reapers. Crackle Dragons. Wagon wheels.
throbbing copperheads.
Great. I'll take them all.
What's this for, man?
I'm gonna shoot them at my neighbor's house and hopefully give him a heart attack.
Cool. In that case, I need this. The Atomic Warlord.
Wow. Good night, Steve. Good night, buddy. Oh! Not a creature was stirring. Not even a mouse. You want lights, buddy? You want lights? I'll show you lights. Sleep through that, buddy. Huh? Huh? Woo! Yeah! How'd that feel, huh? Now you think they can see that from space, buddy? Yeah. Oh, yeah. Woo! How does it feel to have your whole world exploding around you? I really wish that hadn't happened.
Honey?
Watering that thing? It went up awfully fast.
Are you kidding me?
Fire extinguisher.
Oh.
Yeah, yeah. Faulty Christmas lights, an underwater tree. What can I say? We're a cautionary tale.
So the fact that you, apparently purchased an illegal-grade military firework and set it off in your own home had nothing to do with it, huh?
That could have been a contributing factor.
What about this?
Never seen that before in my life.
You're getting to be a knot in my panties, mister. A real knot.
All right, let's go!
Hey, kids. What are you, Where are you going? Huh? Hey,
Father.
Madison. What's going on? Kelly. Kelly, what are you doing?
I'm trying to salvage at least part of this Christmas for the kids.
What? What? Wait, no, you're leaving? Oh, come on, it's not that bad. It's not that bad. Most of the smoke damage was confined to the family room. And on the bright side, hey, you always hated that wallpaper. Now that high-pressure hoses have completely ripped it off the walls,
we're gonna go stay in the motel with Tia and the twins.
Oh, come on, Kelly. Don't do that. Don't let that jerk ruin our Christmas.
The only jerk ruining Christmas around here is you.
Me?
Yeah.
Me? I'm trying to save Christmas.
Really? What is your favorite Christmas memory?
Well, you know what it is. I was 7 years old. My dad and I moved to Alabama, and on Christmas morning, we woke up and sat on the kitchen floor. Ate French fries and drank chocolate milk.
Yeah, exactly. It wasn't planned. It wasn't organized. Nobody had to enter it into their BlackBerry. It just happened.
But our family's so busy, we have to plan things out.
No, you are the busy one. You said this year our kids needed Christmas more than ever. No, what they need more than ever is you. Carter wanted to go Christmas shopping with you. And he wanted to cut down that tree with you. And Madison, well,
Madison's a teenage girl, so she just pretty much ignored you. But if you'd been paying attention, you would have seen that she just wants you to know that she's not a little girl anymore.
Yeah, well, that's a message I got pretty clear.
You just don't get it. Christmas traditions are born in those little chocolate milk and french fry moments. And you can't control it. We don't fit in the tiny little boxes on your Christmas calendar.
Oh, don't. What do I eat?
Oh, wait, Kelly, don't! Wait!
Whoa! Steve! What happened to your house? Did you have a fire?
Wait, are you trying to tell me you weren't even home last night?
No! Look, T and the girls went and stayed at a motel. I spent all night throwing little pebbles at their window to try to get them to talk to me.
You missed the whole...
Oh, that's nothing.
What is this?
That's nothing. Huh? That's just like the kids probably left it out here last night. That's just a wire that goes.
Oh, I knew it. You've been stealing my power.
Borrowing. Look, it's an extension cord. It goes both ways. I was going to shoot it right back to you after the holidays.
Okay, fine. You win. You win. The skating, the lights, the trees. You've been two steps ahead of me the whole time. But you know what? You're still a screw-up. And that doesn't change because you put some lights on the roof.
Hey, pal. You're going to be spending Christmas alone, just like the rest of us screw-ups. How do you like that?
I see you're taking down all the lights.
Oh, you noticed. What are you, some kind of genius?
Apparently not. I can't do it, buddy. I can't spend Christmas without them.
Tell me about it. This is awful. It's killing me. Hey, you know Tia. She's so stubborn. She won't even talk to me. I tried everything.
Maybe not everything.
Girls, come over here. Help us decorate the tree.
Mom. You're hanging booze from the minibar on a branch that you got out of the bumper of a car. Pardon me for not being in the Christmas spirit.
We're trying to make the best of it, honey.
Yeah, you girls put those books down and get your butts over here. Are you reading?
Emily Dickinson. Madison gave it to us. It's really good. Yeah, and it's not giving me a headache or anything. Maybe I should go to law school or something.
Hey, Mom, look! Carter, get back here!
Carter, get back here, you little fart! Mom, you won't believe this. You guys have to come.
Carter? It's like a path! Let's see where it goes!
Oh, my.
were Dad's lights.
I begged you to let me do the yams.
I could tell right away you had no feeling for starches.
Your three-bean salad is very bad.
What'd you expect me to do? The three-bean salad and the fiesta corn? We thought maybe you'd be hungry.
You thought some lights and a TV dinner would make up for all the crap that I have... Is that what I think it is?
We didn't have time to do a turkey.
So we made a few things from your new cookbook.
I got you this little pre-Christmas gift.
I missed you so much.
Now, let's just say we're not going to use our credit cards for the rest of our lives.
You've been busy.
Kelly, I'm so sorry. It's just everything got so... You go along thinking you're doing all the right things for all the right reasons, and then one day you blow up your house. And it occurs to you that somewhere along the way, things got out of hand.
It just seemed like your whole life had gotten so loud that the only thing you were going to hear was an empty house.
You're right. You're right. And you're right to leave. You were, I understand. You're all right to leave. And I'm so glad you're back.
So I can date now?
Sailors during wartime? No. But, you are growing up, so, I guess I have to get used to that.
Mr. Hall, you took down all your lights.
Yeah, I thought it would be better.
Yeah, I bet it would have worked.
Yeah, it might have.
Yeah, I bet they could have seen our house from space.
We'll never know.
Then again, maybe you will.
Look, I'm sorry. You'll have to go home. There are no lights tonight.
Nope, but there will be.
Buddy, what's happening?
I don't know.
I told them Buddy was a little short on lights, and maybe they'd like to come and help out.
How many people did you call?
You have no idea how bad the eyesight is in this town.
MTV is sending someone down to do a story on Buddy's lights. They don't know he took them down.
Which is why we better put him back up. Well, you're just gonna stand there? You're gonna help me do this thing? Those are good, too.
Hey, thanks for coming. That's really nice of you. Beautiful. Good to see you. Steve, you're doing an excellent job. You got a future in this.
Happy holidays, everyone. Susan Park coming to you live from Cloverdale, Massachusetts, where apparently the whole town has come out to see if Buddy Hall, a local car salesman, can achieve the impossible. He's put up a Christmas light display in his front yard that can hopefully be seen from space. Now, the folks at My Earth have been monitoring the situation live. Guys, thanks so much for spending your holiday plans with us.
Oh, no, that's no trouble at all. Actually, it's funny, Basil's mum stopped by with a tin of biscuits, so we're just having a laugh.
Oh, Good times. Good times.
They're gonna do it! They're gonna turn on the lights!
All right, it looks like the moment has finally arrived.
Come on, let's do this as a family. Come on. Put your hand on it. Ready?
All right, Buddy. Yeah. Everybody ready?
Yeah.
On the count of three. One, two, three.
Oh. People work so hard, they'd be so disappointed.
I'm gonna go get some candles.
Okay. All right. I need light.
Mm-hmm.
Want to borrow my phone?
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining.
It is the night of our dear Savior's birth.
Hey, Dad, wouldn't it be great if we could do this every Christmas?
What do you think?
Yeah, we could use some new traditions around here.
I really like this town. I think maybe you could ask for your job back and we could stay here.
Yeah, I like it too.
You do?
I'll get my job back. I'll get my job back. Hey, Steve. I know everything got really crazy, but I just wanted you to know that when we first met, I wasn't lying. I really did want to be your friend.
I know you did. I should have let you.
It's Christmas. Anything can happen. Can we start over?
Nice to meet you. I'm Steve Finch. You are?
Buddy Hall.
Merry Christmas, buddy.
You too, Steve.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did it?